Google recently announced their self-driving cars have been in 11 crashes. Ever. Like, ever. But I've never been in a car accident, so does that make me better than them? Greetings, programs. Thanks for watching DNews Today. I'm Trace. This week, the Associated Press reported Google's self-driving cars were involved in 11 minor crashes over 6 years. Is that a lot? Not according to Google. They count it as a win that their cars have driven 1 million automated miles of testing in the 6 years they've been at it, and they have only been in these few fender benders. By comparison, the human population crashes about 0.3 times for every 100,000 miles driven per driver, according to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration. Which, actually, if you do that math, Google's stats aren't much better. They're 0.6 per 100,000. So why are they spending so much money to develop a self-driving car that doesn't seem safer? Because many non-fatal crashes just go unreported. So it's very likely that 0.3 crashes per 100,000 miles isn't even accurate. There may be as many as 5 million crashes not on the books. On top of that, 94% of all crashes ever are caused by human failure. We are the absolute worst at driving. Cell phone bans don't actually reduce crashes. Drunk driving prohibitions don't stop drunk drivers. Speed limits don't stop speeders, and so on and so on. Instead, fatalities are still in the tens of thousands every year. In fact, the reason that there were collisions with the self-driving cars at all was because of driver frickin' error. Sources say the cars have been rear-ended mostly, but they've also been sideswiped and hit by a car that ran a red light or a stop sign. Since the crash specifics are secret, we can't be entirely certain, but Google says that the car was never at fault, and 8 of those crashes were on city streets. If you buy their spin, then yes, the cars probably are safer. And private cars are just the tip of the iceberg. We're also going to be seeing autonomous vehicles enter the commercial space. Earlier this month, auto manufacturer Daimler unveiled its self-driving semi-truck. The Inspiration truck can drive itself on the highway and only needs a human operator in urban areas. On top of that, they can network on the road and drive in a caravan, getting improved gas mileage as a crew by taking advantage of the slipstream of the truck in front of them. Basically, only the truck in front has to fully cut through the air. The rest draft and get a mileage boost. The Bureau of Transportation Statistics estimates that commercial freight logged 3.3 trillion ton miles in 2012 alone, and that trucks represented 38% of that, or about 1.3 trillion miles. That's a lot of ground to cover for the Inspiration truck or other similar commercial trucks. Aside from Google and Daimler, Audi and Nissan have also developed self-driving cars. Tesla announced the Model S will have autonomous features within a few months, so the future is pretty much here. The National Highway Traffic Safety Administration ranks self-driving vehicles and both the Google cars and the Inspiration truck as level 3 autonomous vehicles. It's not unlike an airplane on autopilot. They can travel autonomously, but quote, the driver is expected to be available for occasional control, given sufficiently comfortable transition time. So the car can't just toss it to the driver when something goes wrong, but then who is at fault if the driver wasn't actually driving and Google programmed the thing? So what happens? At this point, no one knows. California, Nevada, Michigan, Florida, and Washington, D.C. are the only places that license self-driving cars so far. And there are only 48 autonomous vehicles registered in California, and 23 of those are Google's. In the end, these laws are still so new, and the technology isn't entirely proven. So driving a million autonomous miles is kind of piddly compared to the trillions traveled by truck drivers every year in the U.S. alone. What do you think? Are you looking forward to a future where you just never have to drive yourself? How about a future where cars are powered by salt water? Julian has more of that in this video.
German company Nanoflow Cell debuted their Quant-E Sport Limousine at the Geneva Motor Show this year, and its goal is to be the first saltwater-powered production car in the world.
Thanks for watching DNews, everybody. Make sure you subscribe so you keep getting more of our videos every day of the week.